In this video, we will discuss about spherical soft contact lens fitting. Contact lens fitting can be divided into two types. 1. Empirical fitting. 2. Diagnostic fitting. Empirical fitting involves fitting of contact lens based on total diameter, keratometer reading, back vertex calculation and manufacturer guidelines without use of any trial contact lens. Where diagnostic fitting involves fitting of contact lens based on total diameter, keratometer reading, back vertex calculation and manufacturer guidelines with use of trial contact lens on patient's eye before final prescription. Diagnostic fitting is considered as standard fitting method. We will discuss about diagnostic fitting in this video. Complete process of soft spherical contact lens fitting can be divided into three segments. A. Baseline measurement. B. Trial lens parameter choice. C. Fitting assessment. In baseline measurement, we will discuss about 1. Slit length. 2. Horizontal iris visible diameter. 3. Palpable fissure height. 4. Pupil size measurement. 5. Keratometry. 6. Additional test. In trial lens parameter choice, we will discuss about 1. Base curve. 2. Total diameter. 3. Estimation of contact lens power. In fitting assessment, we will discuss about 1. Centration. 2. Coverage. 3. Movement. 4. Lag. 5. Push-up. 6. Comfort. 7. Aids. And 8. Modification. Now, let's start with baseline measurement. 1. Slit lamp examination. Slit lamp examination is done to identify any pathology in the eye and its surrounding structures. Slit lamp is generally observed accordingly: lids or lashes, conjunctiva, both bulbar and palpebral, limbus, cornea, tear film, anterior chamber, iris and lens. Two, horizontal iris visible diameter or HVID. Here in this figure, this is horizontal iris visible diameter. Normal HVID varies 10 to 14 mm. And average HVID is 11.7 mm. HVID is important to identify the total diameter of soft contact lens. It can be measured horizontally through the center of cornea by several instruments, even with normal mm scale in primary gaze. Total diameter is equal to HVID plus 2 mm. Available methods are normal millimeter scale, slit lamp, corneal topographer, Barnard scale. 3. Palpable fissure height or PFH. Here in this figure, this is palpable fissure height. The normal PFH varies 9 to 11 mm and average PFH 10 mm. It is the distance between upper and lower lid margin vertically through the center of cornea when patient looking at primary gaze. Higher PFH patients are suggested for large diameter contact lens and vice versa. Available methods are normal millimeter scale, slit lamp, topographer, Barnard scale. 4. Pupil size. Pupil size is important to identify optical zone of the soft contact lens. Normal pupil size in bright light condition 2 to 4 mm, in dim light condition 4 to 8 mm. In contact lens practice, pupil size is measured in dim light condition. Optical zone equal to pupil size in dim light plus 2 mm. Available methods are normal millimeter scale, corneal topographer, Barnard scale. Here in this figure, this is pupil size. 5. Keratometry to identify base curve of the soft contact lens. Formula: base curve is equal to 337.5 divided by D. Here, D is equal to drive trick value of average K. 6. Additional test. A. Iris color. B. Tear film evaluation. It is generally done by Schammer test, tear breakup time test, tear meniscus height, non-invasive tear breakup time test. Trial lens parameter choice for soft spherical contact lens fitting, and we will cover 1. Base curve. 2. Total diameter. 3. Estimation of contact lens power. Now let's start with base curve. Base curve is the radius of curvature of back surface of contact lens. Here in this figure, this is contact lens. This is front surface of this contact lens. This is back surface of this contact lens. एंड दिस इज रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर ऑफ बैक सरफेस ऑफ दिस कॉन्टैक्ट लेंस और बेस कर्व ऑफ दिस कॉन्टैक्ट लेंस. बेस कर्व शुड बी 0.621 mm फ्लैटर देन एवरेज स्केयर रीडिंग. फॉर बिगिनर इट्स बेटर टू स्टार्ट विथ 1 mm फ्लैटर देन एवरेज स्केयर रीडिंग. बेस कर्व इज आइडेंटिफाई बाई यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला बेस कर्व इज इक्वल टू 337.5 डिवाइडेड बाई डी. हेयर डी इज डायोप्टिक वैल्यू ऑफ एवरेज के. सपोज स्केरोडोमीटर रीडिंग्स आर K1 44 डायोप्टर एट 180 डिग्री एंड K2 46 डायोप्टर एट 90 डिग्री. हेयर एवरेज के इज 45 डायोप्टर. सो व्हाट विल बी द बेस कर्व? लेट्स सी इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. हेयर एवरेज के इज 45 डायोप्टर. The formula used to identify the average K is K1 plus K2 divided by 2 or 44 plus 46 divided by 2 or 90 divided by 2 or 45 diopter. According to formula, base curve is equal to 337.5 divided by D or base curve is equal to 337.5 divided by 45 or base curve is equal to 7.50. So, base curve is 7.50 mm. Now, as we have to choose 0.621 mm flatter base curve, so our final base curve will be base curve is equal to 7.50 plus 1 mm or base curve is equal to 8.50 mm. So, final base curve of this soft contact lens is 8.50 mm. Now, let's start with total diameter. Total diameter is the width of the contact lens from edge to edge and it is expressed in millimeter. Here in this figure, this is the distance between edge to edge or total diameter. The total diameter should be 2 mm greater than the horizontal visible iris diameter. The formula is total diameter is equal to HBID plus 2 mm. If HBID is 12 mm, then our total diameter will be the total diameter is equal to 12 plus 2 mm. So, total diameter of this soft contact lens is 14 mm. Now, let's start with estimation of contact lens power. Contact lens power is estimated using the formula back vertex power of contact lens is equal to FSP divided by 1 minus D multiplied by FSP. Here, FSP is equal to spectacle power, D is equal to vertex distance in meter and back vertex power of contact lens is equal to estimated contact lens power for trial lens. Suppose spectacle power in both eye is minus 5 diopter and vertex distance is 12 mm. So what will be our estimated contact lens power? Let's solve it in next slide. Here FSP is equal to minus 5 diopter. D is equal to 12 mm or 0.012 meter. So, what will be the estimated contact lens power? According to formula, FSP divided by 1 minus D multiplied by FSP or minus 5 divided by 1 minus 0.012 multiplied by minus 5 or minus 5 divided by 1 plus 0.012 multiplied by 5 or minus 5 divided by 1 plus 0.06 or minus 5 divided by 1.06 or minus 4.72 diopter or minus 4.75 diopter. So estimated contact lens power for minus 5 diopter is minus 4.75 diopter. Fitting assessment of spherical soft contact lens fitting, and we will cover 1 centration, 2 coverage, 3 movement, 4 leg, 5 push up, 6 comfort, 7 aids and 8 modification. First, centration. Centration means superimposition of center of cornea and center of contact lens. Here in this figure, this is cornea, this is center of cornea, this is soft contact lens and this is superimposition of center of contact lens and cornea. The amount of limber overlap is normal. corneal coverage maintains in all positions. Now, how to document centration? In optimal fit, it will be centered. In stiff fit, it will also centered. In flat fit, it will be decentered. Now, coverage. About 1 mm symmetrical overlap is ideal. Here in this figure, this is cornea, this is soft contact lens, and this is 1 mm symmetrical overlap. Ideal coverage is important for shape regularity, prevent trauma to cornea, limbus and conjunctiva, prevent corneal exposure and desiccation, prevent tear film disturbance. Now, how to document coverage? In optimal fit, it will be complete cover. In stiff fit, it will be decentered or poor recovery. And in flat fit, often Wright's law. Now, movement. Movement is required due to removes and disperses ocular debris, promotes tear exchange, epithelial wetting by mucin spreading. Lens movement depends on lens type, lens design, lens material, fitting relationship, lids factor, anterior eye topography. Now, how to document movement? In optimal fit, it will be 0.3 mm. In stiff fit, it will be less than 2 mm. In flat fit, it will be more than 1 mm. 4. Leg. Leg refers to the resistance of the lens to move with the eye in any gaze from its primary gaze. Here in this figure, this is cornea and this is soft contact lens. The lens centration is noted with the eye looking up gaze while patient is instructed to maintain their eye position and not to blink. Here in this figure, this is cornea, this is soft contact lens, and this is leg while patient is seeing in up gaze position. Now, how to document leg? In optimal fit, the leg will be 1.5 mm. In stiff fit, it will be little or none. In flat fit, it will be more than 2 mm. 5. Push up. In this test, the lens is pushed upward with the help of lower lid and then lens recovery is observed. Here in this figure, you can see the lens is pushing upward with the help of lower lid. Now, how to document push up? In optimal fit, it will be quick recovery. In stiff fit, it will be slow or nil recovery, and in flat fit, it will quick recovery. 6. Comfort. In optimal fit, comfort will be good. In stiff fit, the comfort will be initially good, and in flat fit, the comfort will be poor. 7. Edge. In optimal fit, there will be no indentation. In stiff fit, there will be indentation, and in flat fit, it will be flooding. 8. Modification. In optimal fit, modification is not required. In stiff fit, we need flatter base curve or decrease total diameter. And in flat fit, we need steeper base curve or increase total diameter. This was very short presentation on spherical soft contact lens fitting. In upcoming video, we will describe details about each and every point of spherical soft contact lens fitting.